Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy, a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Morning.
Can we learn something from the lab, knowing that China would be running interference there? Is there something you can learn from data?
The Chinese are never going to let us really get in there and dig into this thing appropriately. There's going to be threats and everything, but they basically, you know, have control of the situation, and they don't trust us. We don't trust them. I think nothing is going to come out of this. It's just going to be, yes, it's plausible. Okay, that may be the case. We may never know any more than we know today.
Let's talk about this CDC study. They did something about with essential workers, and these are the kind of numbers that you were talking about before, but 90% of the time, those vaccines are working and you don't get real sick. Is that new information?
No, it's new information that just confirms information we already knew. In other words, in this group of almost 4,000 healthcare workers, or essential workers, excuse me, the effect is about 90% preventing symptomatic disease with COVID, and really 100% preventive in severe disease and hospitalization and death. So it just confirms what we already knew, but it's reassuring.
And talk about vaccines for younger people. When people hear emergency use, I think that makes them nervous. How much confidence can we have in emergency use?
Well, emergency use means we'll kill people if we wait for a full approval. And a full approval is a minimum of 6 months following the group that was studied. So they allow emergency use at 2 months. And that's really the only difference. All the other safety stuff has already been done. And the thing is, it's more dangerous to wait for full approval. That's really what it means. So unfortunately, the word emergency, that's the emergency for the whole pandemic and the risk to everybody in the pandemic. The vaccines are safe. They've been now given to, you know, hundreds of millions of people. We know what's going to happen with those things. What we don't know is why some people get long haul syndrome with COVID, and why the hospitals now are full of have many adolescents and teenagers who haven't been able to get vaccinated yet, and children.
All right, let's get to viewer questions. I heard that taking anti-inflammatory drugs are showing a reduced response to the COVID vaccine. I didn't know one of the meds I was taking was one, and now I'm concerned about my protection. I'm no longer taking that medicine. Should I get another vaccination or an early booster?
Well, this is a good question. The CDC actually had a publication with some guidance in it on April 19th of this year. Doesn't say much, not very helpful. It just says, talk to your doctor. Okay, so you talk to your doctor, and the doctor goes, I don't know, there's no guidance that says what to do. So the facts is, if you were taking non-steroidal anti-inflammatories, or if you were taking steroids, the response to the vaccine is going to be blunted. Now, is it blunted enough to not make it work? That's the question. There's no tests. Forget trying to do any tests to figure out if it worked or not. The thing is, if you've got some risk factor to get really ill, you may want to talk to your doctor and see if your doctor recommends a booster. That is what the guidance is right now.
All right, next question. I was fully vaccinated as of January 8th, 2021. Do I need a booster soon?
Well, that's another good question. As of today, no. So those cohorts of people that were in those 30-person studies, they're being followed very closely. And if they see a drop off in the immunity that the vaccine delivered to that person, they'll start recommending the booster. So there have been some talk between the NIH people and the CEO of Pfizer that, you know, you may need this in 8 months to a year. But, you know, they're following those patients. And so far, we don't need it. But that announcement will come out as soon as the science shows that you do need a booster. Most likely you will, but the timing is really when. And this for the person in the first question, as soon as anyone says get a booster, that person should jump to the front of the line.
All right, if you have a question for Dr. Murphy, you can post it on our Morning News Facebook page. We'll talk to him again tomorrow. Thanks, doctor.
Thanks, doctor.
Hey, Paul.
Hi, you guys. Looking at cloudy skies across.